Fiona McFarlane here at Boomtown in Krakow, and I'm here with Philip De Brouwer from HSBC. Philip, introduce yourself.
Yes, hello. My name is Philip De Brouwer, and I work for HSBC since the last 3.5 years. Before that, I worked for the Royal Bank of Scotland in London, and I joined Krakow here to build up a risk team for HSBC. A fantastic decision. I think it was the best decision of my life. I really enjoy being in Krakow. I really enjoy working for HSBC, and we really make a difference here. You see, 5 years ago, if you studied mathematics here in Krakow, there weren't so many employment options. Maybe you could stay in academic research or leave the town and go to London, for example. Mm-hmm. But now we have built up a labor market for people with a mathematical background here. We do very highly specialized and highly technically sensitive things for the bank here in Krakow. We have a team of 100 people for model review. We're building up another team for making financial models. We are doing things that sit after the financial markets, after the big trades and these kind of things. Mm-hmm. All specializations, all things that actually 5 years ago people thought it is impossible to offshore because it is too complex. There is no clear process behind. It is too much value added. It's too sensitive. You have to keep it close to the headquarters. I think now we have proven that it can work. You can offshore such things. And I strongly believe that that is one of the important things that makes Krakow different from all the other service centers. You see, when you look at the top 100 of service center locations in the world, Krakow has recently jumped to position 6, which is fantastic. It's only, together with Dublin, is the only European town in the top 10.
That's very impressive.
It is, absolutely. And now with the wave of robotics coming along, you will expect that a lot of more simple, more procedural jobs will just disappear. Many of the jobs that we do today, in 10 years, they won't exist anymore. But the type of jobs that will still exist are the jobs that create value, that change things, that program those robots. And that is the type of jobs that Krakow seems to excel. Krakow seems to excel as no other location for service center where people take responsibility, think with you, challenge things, change things, and improve things.
Very interesting. You spoke a lot about the new direction where tech talent is heading. And one thing that I'm really concerned about is with technology moving us forward, we're going to need a lot of staff that are tech forward. But if that happens, then where is diversity? That remains, I believe, one of the important things. Is HSBC worried about diversity?
Yes, absolutely. It's actually very high on the agenda. You see, indeed, jobs will change. It won't be the same anymore. There will be different jobs than you have today. And as in any jobs, there is some jobs are more male heavy, some are more female heavy. And you might think if the programming jobs become more important, well, more males are there, so it might be a tough time for ladies. But then if you think a second time, you'll probably realize that, well, men and women are different. We have different strengths. We complete each other. And that is also the way that we will use the machines. They have their own strengths and they makes us stronger as human race, so to speak. And the type of things that are very hard for a computer, that are the things that come natural for us. Like picking up a glass and drinking, or understanding emotions. These are things that are very difficult for computers. Whereas these type of things come natural for us. And the things that come natural for a computer is crunching the big numbers, for example. And then you will see that typical strengths of women is probably like the higher emotional quotient, like the more inclusive way of thinking, like more the focus on making sure that everybody is on board. And that type of things will probably gain importance. So overall, I think it will be a balanced approach.
And one of the hot topics that everyone is talking about is diversity. Philippe, why is it so important and why is everyone talking about it?
Yes, that's a very interesting question, actually. And I would have probably two or maybe even three answers to that. You see, the first answer is probably the most important. It's probably because it's the right thing to do. a situation right now is an inherited situation which is fundamentally unfair. Mm-hmm. Different parts of the population don't have the natural participation rate in many things that is going on. It is just because it is the right thing to do. A second thing is that, well, we have a lot of studies these days that show that diversity goes very well hand in hand with increased profitability. And when you think about that argument, that becomes really very powerful. Because you see, for the first time since the dawn of the industrialization in the 1700s, we are faced with an inverse population curve. We have less children than we have adults, and soon we will have less adults than we have retired people. So we will need those robots. And also, for the first time in history, our computers are powerful enough where robots can do things that seems magical, or things that we thought that only humans could do, like being creative or recognizing things for which we have certain concepts and machines not. And so you know that things will change. You know that things will dramatically change, and you know that you won't be prepared for it. Mm-hmm. And the best way to be prepared for such profound change is to have all different type of people on board, with all different types of vision on life, on vision on how things are, people with different backgrounds. And that is probably for me the most important argument, because it is only when you have those different views on board and you have the inclusive environment where people feel free to speak up that you will have the important trends mm-hmm. of the future on board in the company. And that is the best way to prepare the company for the future.